It's quite interesting to see what other ports are doing within the SADC region. We are not really far from the process that they're following. It's almost quite similar. It's just that when it comes to certain challenges, for example, like electricity or the climate condition, I think that's where we in Namibia are more on the safer side. My presentation outline, I'll only focus on three items. Show where Namibia is. We are a fairly small nation, only 2.7 million people. So it's always important to show on the map where we are located. I'll speak a bit about Namport, and then share with you our journey towards port automation implementation. Namibia is in the southern part of Africa. As I said, we are only 2.7 million people. Our western border is the Atlantic Ocean. Angola and Zambia are our neighbors to the northern part. And we have Botswana on the eastern side, the eastern part. And we have South Africa to the south and east part as our neighbors. Now, our governance structure as Namport is a bit different if I compare it to the Port of Beira and Sogesta. We are both the port authority and the port operator. The authority was established in 1994 by an act of parliament. We manage two ports in Namibia, or the only two ports in Namibia, the port of Walvis Bay and the port of Lodrecht in the southern part of Namibia. The port of Walvis Bay is situated at the southwest coast of Africa and provide easier and much faster transit route to regional and global economic hubs. The port of Lodrecht, as I said, located in the southern coast of Namibia, it caters for activities, mining activities in the southern part of Namibia, as well as providing access to markets in the Northern Cape of South Africa. We are very much strong in servicing the hinterland of SADC via the Walvis Bay corridor. We service Zambia and DRC through the Walvis Bay Ndola Lubumbashi corridor. We service Botswana and the economic hub of Southern Africa, Johannesburg, via the Trans-Kalahari corridor. And we have also linkage with the southern part of Angola on the land side through the Trans-Kunene corridor. And then the fairly small port, the port of Lodrecht, caters for the activities in the Northern Cape of South Africa via the Trans-Orange corridor. We are connected to the global economic hub through on the maritime side. We have all the on the water side, we have all the major shipping lines calling the port of Walvis Bay. Just to share some statistics with you, this is in the previous financial year, we handled 3.2 million cargo landed, and we shipped 2.2 million ton of cargo. And what we transshipped was only 112,000 tons. And in terms of, just put it on presentation mode, sorry. And in terms of TU handled, the previous financial year, we landed 70,551 TUs, and we shipped 64,000 TUs, and we transshipped 13,461 TU. Well, there are various factors that actually drove Namport to really look fast-track port automation and digitalization. And what we look at is how connected are we to the entire world, the rising customer expectation. We're constantly under pressure to increase productivity with the cascading effect. We are experiencing the growth of vessels. Previously, we were handling vessels only up to 5,000 TU. Now we have actually seen double the size of that. We are also cognizant of the protection of the environment. And we believe that, you know, through automation, that will lead also to the protection of the environment. The other factor is the operational excellence. On a continuous basis, we are under pressure from our clients to for operational consistency, increased productivity, and efficiencies. The other factor is also one to leverage from the technology to improve our business operations. I'll only focus on our journey insofar as the implementation of our terminal operation system is concerned. Well, we also have partially automated activities on the seaside and also on the administration side, but I will not focus on those. Well, as I said, we established in 1994. So in terms of volume throughput, it was very much minimal. We were actually part of the South African port network in that the first terminal operating system that was introduced was an in-house one called GCOS. It was actually developed in South Africa. And this system would only be effective for terminals with a volume throughput of 20,000. So we had that system up until 2009, when we started hitting 70,000 TU throughput. So the first formal terminal operating system that we introduced was Navis. So that actually helped us a lot in yard and vessel planning, gate control, EDI integration, reefer monitoring, because previously it was all manually done. So from 2010 to 2015, we had the old version of Navis. When our new container terminal was constructed as of 2014, we already planned to upgrade the old Navis system in order to be able to be introduced to the new terminal that was commissioned 2 years ago. So as we speak, we have upgraded the nervous system, which incorporate the business intelligence component. We are now almost close to also incorporating the billing system to have a watertight process from quayside operation, yard planning, up to the billing component. Now, as Namport, we do not only handle containers, we also have a terminal or a multi-purpose terminal that have been operating without a system for quite some time. We have a multi-purpose terminal and a ship repair facility. 2 years ago, we went out on tender, and the successful tenderer was Logstar. So we are at the final stages to go live. So this system, if it was not for COVID, I think we were already going to be live first quarter of this year, of last year, sorry. But because of the new norm, there were some serious delays with restrictions, travel restrictions of the trainers that were supposed to come through. But we are quite confident that once we go live, we'll definitely see a lot of improvement. We will minimize, or we will improve on wastage, reduce cost of running our operations at this terminal, and also get closer to a platform where we can integrate other service provider to have access to this platforms. Well, I have a small video here of Logstar, but due to time, I'll not be able to play it. With the new terminal, we have also partially automated our RTD operation, Calma, with the smart rail software, are the ones that are assisting us in running this this operation. With the STSs, we are also at the final stage of concluding a deal with ABB to also automate our STS cranes. Partially automate the STS cranes to enhance our operations at the new container terminal. Well, so far what we have established is that we have really increased our operational efficiencies at the container terminal. We have reduced operational costs and really boost sustainability and enhance return on investment. From the Namibian side, I think this is where I end. Thank you, Dinesh.